What is wrestling? This is Aspectrum here. Welcome back to another episode of Room Number 9. As if you guys haven't checked it out already, there's a new series up on my channel, and apparently the demo is really truly an extended demo, and I mean extended. In other words, from what I've been told, it's depending on how you play it, I guess, it could be from 6 to 7 hours long. And I'm talking about the Divine Speaker. So if you haven't checked it out, check that out. So we did a first episode, and that looks like it's going to be kind of like a mini series, which is awesome. And you guys know, if you guys have been watching any of my videos for the last year now, at least I would say year and a half, you know that how excited I am for the Divine Speaker, as that game has loads and loads of potential. And the fact that they're giving us a 7-hour extended demo tells me everything, that they are not only, you know, like exploring everything they can and taking their time in a good way, but it seems like it's going to be very in-depth too, possibly even more than Lamento. I don't know, but I'm getting the Lamento vibes from it, and it makes me happy that they're fleshing out the world and doing it in a manner that makes sense, amongst other things. But anyways, I just wanted to give that play out there in case you guys haven't checked it out, because I know sometimes YouTube can be very weird about push notifications. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. That's just how it is. But anyways, we're here for Room Number 9, and I'm sure you're ready for this episode, as the reason why I stopped it last episode, like where we are now, is because there's dots. And if you guys played enough BL games for the most part, you know, like anyone knows, that when dots happen and it goes to Blackstone, especially from Parade, there's some stretching that happens afterwards. So that's why I'm talking to you guys now, just in case things go down in the yoga mat, if you know what I mean. But anyways, without further ado, let's go ahead and continue on some more Room Number 9. And if you guys don't see me here on YouTube, as I make a weird cut to scene after, you'll know why. Because yoga stretching. Anyways. Oh, wow. We go immediately the next day and 52 points. And hello, YouTube, as we're here. Sorry again. I'm just giving you guys a heads up. This is going to be a short episode. Like, it sounds like we're in the car. Does it not? Anyways, it's good to see you guys again on YouTube. Yeah, like I said, there is that awkward things happen. In other words, we went with Task A again, and it went actually pretty smoothly. So the difference this time around, just to give you guys an idea, they were actually communicating this time with each other. It was very difficult though, because again, you can't touch a certain area, because then that's what the task said, as you guys remember from the task thing. Yeah, he couldn't touch the tennis racket, if you will. And in order to like fulfill the task, they thought, you know, it was the best thing to do. We got to create a pizza. So they created a pizza by putting the pepperonis and like being very aggressive with the pepperonis, right? And along with that, they had to include a pizza cutter, because, you know, you gotta shape it up, right? If you know. And all, not only that, but you also get to put some good grease on that, because, you know, you got to make it nice and greasy and juicy. And yeah, we finished it off with some Alfredo sauce, so that's kind of what happened. That's pretty much all you missed. But again, if you want to see that again, it's only going to be up on Patreon. $1 a month gives you full access to that. So if you guys want to check it out, Patreon link in the description down below. We don't have too much time. We probably have like 10 minutes. So yeah, let's continue on this episode. It's going to be a shorter episode, but you kind of expected that when there's a big cut in between. Day 6. We'd almost been here almost a full week. Just 5 to go. Assuming everything went well. I really hope it would. I was lying in bed thinking about ways we could escape. The first step would be getting through the exchange chamber by like faking an illness or something. But I was sure they wouldn't take the bait, and that would be that. I wish I could come up with a good idea. Maybe it'd be a little less obnoxious if the alarm was birds chirping. Not that it made much of a difference at this point. I could sense Seiji stirring on the other side of the bed while I was still laying around. I didn't want to move. I just wanted to sleep forever. Who cares about breakfast? The sheets are torn from my body, and the icy air-conditioned air immediately enveloped my body, but I still didn't want to get up. We put on the TV while we ate our breakfast and ended up chatting about the whatever was on the news. But he seems a silent look. That's right. If something was going on outside, it should have made an effect on this place. Seiji got up and put his ear to the wall. He shushed me and I closed my mouth. I press my ear to the wall, close my eyes, and concentrate on the sound. Shh. The sound I could hear were a mix of things. Running water, maybe, and a ventilation fan. A combination of things like that. It might have been the sound of a typhoon, but I had no way of knowing whether it was or not. I couldn't exactly keep my ear glued to the wall constantly, either. The university campus was pretty hot during the summer, since the concrete would soak up the heat and radiate into the building. Just what kind of building is this? It didn't make much sense. Just 5 more days. I hope we can hold out that long and then get out of here. I expected him to make a really displeased face, but he didn't. Since he actually looked very calm and collected, just like he always did. Seiji picked up the tablet and breezed through the menus with practiced fingers. What would it be this time? I wasn't even sure I cared anymore. Oh, okay. Subject A and B must mutually stimulate their... Ooh. Well, it's the famous number. That's the only thing I could think of. They gotta do the famous number 96. I mean, it's true. Am I wrong? I mean, that's the best way they can mutually, give themselves a manicure. I think, at least. I don't know. Is that the best way of doing it? You guys let me know in the comments. But, actually, don't tell me. I would rather not know. But the thing I would like to know, again, will you choose task 1 or task 2? I'm curious to see how bad task 2 can get. Like, can it get much worse? It sounds like it could get to a certain point in death. But maybe that's why what the video was saying earlier, or in the beginning of the game when they're showing the footage, there was that one person in the exchange chamber like an idiot. Like, there's that. Like, that was just dumb. That was the people showing us that, like, oh yeah, don't go in the exchange chamber because that's going to happen to you. That I feel like that was pretty obvious. But then they show that other one where that one person getting choked out. Like, I feel like task 2 does get super, super, super extreme, which still makes me think that one room, I think it was room number 2, I can't remember. I'm hoping they'll show it again to see if they're still there on the reason why they've been there for a month, because they're probably doing task 1 over and over and over because for them, that's easy. If there is multiple people, we don't know. I think there is 2 people. It must be easy for them because that's all I'm assuming. They're doing task 1 and spending their points. It's a vacation to them. I think I keep saying that, but it's true. I have to keep reiterating that because they're having the time of their lives while everyone else is in L. I doubted my eyes for a moment, and then we looked at each other. Both of us were relieved, but we also both fell silent at the same moment. Was it really easy? How is forcing 2 men to stretch each other off easy? Was easy? Wasn't the fact that we felt that that way evidence was something was wrong with us? Seiji awkwardly closed his mouth and stared off into space. I didn't want to keep feeling like this, but that was probably the better option. At least this time it was one that wasn't totally one-sided. We could share the burden. I started to get curious about what was going on with the other rooms and poked around the tablet to find out. Yep. Oh, now we notice it. I noticed it first. It was 4 now. So every task he can... Ooh, I see. So the longer you wait, the less it's worth. The system's flexible enough to do that. It made sense when I actually thought about it, though. Yeah, see, that's what I was thinking. I was like, this is such a good idea. It's like, we can only do 9 tasks and just, pop the 10 points and we're out. But if it was just always worth 10 points, once you're at 90, you could just make your feed public and immediately hit the target. Risk-free. Yeah, exactly. That's what I was thinking. He had a point. I nodded and looked down at the tablet again. Accent. We were commenting casually on what was showing on TV while we ate. For once, things felt almost normal. Just as I was thinking about it, about the time we got on with it, without any signal, CG got up and headed to the bed. I followed. It was all done just as casually as you might excuse yourself to go to the bathroom. Well, I think Patreon had enough content for one day, but I'm sure the people on Patreon would disagree with that. But again, if you want to see what's going to happen, because we both know what's going to happen next episode. Again, link in the description box down below for Patreon. $1 a month gives you access to that. But I did hope you enjoyed this very, very short episode. I hope you enjoyed some of it as we're progressing this story. But I think we're progressing through the plot points right now, if you know what I mean. But I'm curious to see how Task A is going to go further on. And again, I'm curious to see how much further Task B is going to end up being for everybody. Or Task 2, I should say. But again, let me know in the comments down below. Task 1 or Task 2, which one would you choose? But yeah, I do agree with them. Task, in general, right now, it seems like Task 1... The thing with Task 1 is that at the beginning, it starts off really difficult, especially if you're unfamiliar with that type of stuff, and especially you're not into that type of stuff, you know? It's going to be difficult. It has like a tough learning curve, if you will. That's the worst way to put it, but you know what I mean when I say that. Like, there's that big hump you have to get over, but once you get over that hump, maybe things start getting easier. As they even said, as both of them agreed, now Task 1 seems pretty easy because we did the tough stuff together. But again, Task 1 could definitely get tougher later on. Where I feel like Task B, on the other hand, it's going to be one of those that gradually gets worse and worse. Again, I'm just basing it off on the fact that we had like the warning footage from the beginning of the game where they show that one guy literally choking out somebody to death. Like, I'm assuming that came from Task 2, and that gradually gets worse and worse and worse as it goes on. So maybe, actually, hindsight 2020, of course, Task 1 was probably the better choice than Task 2. But I still stand by what I say. Maybe they should have done some Task 2, but at the same time, we don't know how much worse it can get later on. But again, let me know in the comments down below. And I did hope you enjoyed. If you did, leave a like and share it. If you did enjoy, to subscribe, but subscribing down below. I'll see you awesome later with some more... Rune number 9 later, of course, and I'll also see you some more Divine Speaker demo. And again, you can check that out in my channel link down below, or just my channel, just, you know, click the channel. And of course, I highly suggest you click the bell button next to the subscribe button if you haven't already. If you click on both if you haven't, of course, so you can stay up to date on when I upload videos. And that bell button should give you a push notification when a video comes up. Outside of that, thank you all for watching, and hopefully I'll start live streaming tomorrow. I thought it was going to be tonight, but I have a movie tonight. But maybe after the movie, we'll see. But if you haven't, follow me on Twitch down below. If you haven't, I'll send the link down below in the description down below. Until then, I'll see you all later, okay? Love you. Don't forget to stay awesome.